to which you have been appointed. Do you, Deborah Saucier, pledge yourself to perform the duties of the president of Vancouver University as prescribed by law, and you promise to defend the rules and promote the welfare of the university and members thereof?
I do so pledge myself.
In the name of Vancouver University and its Board of Governors, I now install you, Deborah Saucier, in the office of President and Vice-Chancellor of the University, and I invest you with the authority and charge you with the responsibility pertaining to office. I ask Chancellor Mandel to come forward to present the robe and stole of the office of the President. To my top choice, now formally installed as President of Vancouver University, in a ceremony that pays respect to the culture and traditions of our valued Indigenous partners on whose land we celebrate this momentous occasion, this Nanaimo people. Dr. Saucier is likely the first president to ever be installed in a longhouse.
Continue to excel in our work. I witnessed personally that your sincerity for student success, inclusion, and diversity is genuine. Your clarity and focus is genuine. You care about maintaining the values that Vancouver Island University stands for, and that is genuine. Congratulations, Dr. Saucier. We welcome you with outstretched arms, open mind, and supportive heart.
On behalf of the government, education is key to our future, to our economy, to our children, to Nanaimo, Ladysmith, Sedema. And we are going to need her to be strong. So it is on us to not just lean too heavy on her, but to lift her up and to make sure that she carries out her duties that maybe a pretty demanding Minister of Advanced Education Skills and Training has in mind.
You've heard the word reconciliation numerous times. You know, there's one time when I first got elected to council. That was a far-fetched word. Look at us today. We've come together in a good way. I'm really proud of Deb. When she first approached me to ask if she could have the installation in our home, as a council, we